This spirit, when it manifests, it also gives you a state which we call as collective consciousness. It's the state by which you become, you again I say become, it's actualization, it is not just talking. You become conscious collectively, means you become conscious of another person's centers on your fingertips. You also become self-aware. You know about yourself, what centers are catching, where are we going. Like a person who becomes mentally upset, he does know. Till he becomes mad, goes to lunatic asylum and dies, he does not know. But in Sahaja Yoga, immediately you can find out that there's something going wrong with your mental side. If a person gets into cancer, he might get into the state of galloping cancer, about to die, then he may discover that he has got cancer. But in Sahaja Yoga, if there's a little imbalance, immediately it shows on your fingertips. And if you know how to do it, how to correct it, then every problem is solved. So as I told you yesterday, yoga has double meaning. Yoga means union with the divine. That's one. And the second one is the expertise, the deftness, what we call in Sanskrit kaushalam. You must have the deftness, how to handle this all-pervading power that is flowing through us, how to understand ourselves, how to understand others. That's an important part of Sahaja Yoga. Now the third thing that happens with Self-Realization is that you get a state of peace, of bliss and of joy. When the Kundalini rises above this Agya Chakra, you become thoughtlessly aware. It's called as Nirvichar Samadhi, thoughtlessly aware, where there is no thought in your mind. If you want, you can think. If you want, you can think. But if you don't want, you can be in that state where you don't think. Actually, it's maddening sometimes, the way man is thinking, morning till evening, yarns after yarns, useless things, a joyless pursuit. But when this thinking stops, you're above the thoughts. I would say, to give it a simile, that the waves of thought come and go away. Another thought comes and goes away. We are jumping on the cusp of the thought all the time. Supposing we can just get in the center of the thought, that is the present. If we could stop at the present moment, then we are not worried about the thoughts. Like the waves of water, if you are in the waves, you are frightened of that. But supposing you are in a boat, then you can see the waves and enjoy them. In the same way, what happens to you that you jump up to a higher state of existence through which you see the thoughts. If you want, you don't want to see, you can, you need not see. Now the thoughts that you see also are very wide and deeper, where you get inspirations. That's why, as Dr. Warren has told you, that your creativity improves. You can become tremendously dynamic, because your time is not wasted in wasteful thinking. You just know this is it. This is the exact. This is what we have to do. And that's how people get rid of many of their problems of mental tensions. There's no tension at all. You don't have any worries. You just see the thing like the witness. You become the witness of the whole drama. When you are in the drama, you think you are a part and parcel of the drama. Sometimes you weep with it and cry with it. But when the drama is over, you realize it was just a drama. I was not there. In the same way it happens to you, that you achieve a witness state. It happens to you. Even if you want to get involved, you cannot. You just cannot get it. That's how you can solve the problems better, because you are away from the problems. You can see what the problem is, but when you are in it, you are upset, full of tension, worries. And sometimes people get so upset with it that they commit suicide when they find no solution. But if you are away from it, then you can definitely solve the problem. Now this witness state has to grow within you, gradually, with little understanding and with little meditation, which is very simple, which you can do very easily, nothing has to be done about it. The last center is the center of Sahasrara, they call it, because there are 1,000 petals. 1,000 petals because there are 1,000 nerves which get enlightened. And the light from the flame, as you see in a candle, in the same way, it appears like tongues of flames, beautiful tongues of flame of various colors. You see them opening out. First you don't see, first you become the light, and then you can see it also, that it opens out as a beautiful lotus of flames of beautiful colors. And you stand in between to see that you are there watching all this within yourself. This center has a speciality, that all the centers you have seen, the 6 centers, are placed in the head. This is what we call the station of the centers, or the pithas. The centers are working there, but actually their guarding forces are in the head. And when the Kundalini comes up and she integrates you and enlightens the brain, all these centers also get enlightened, and you feel that you are completely integrated. Your mind, your body, your soul, all work together, there's no fight. You are extremely restful, you are peaceful, and the bliss you feel actually as physical manifestation. For example, if you want to see something very beautiful, you see something very beautiful and you like it, like Mona Lisa's painting now, many people go to see that. They don't know what they like about it, but I know what it is. When you watch that, there's no thought. There's no thought. When there is no thought, the creation of the artist in that photograph or in that painting or in any beautiful scene or anything that you see, the whole thing is reflected within you as if it's a ripple-less ocean or a ripple-less lake in which all the surroundings are reflected completely. And then you feel actually physically as if the joy and the peace is flowing down you, like peaceful happening. You feel that relaxation just coming on you. Physically also you feel it, and you feel extremely charmed by that.